हेलो
यस सर, यस सर।
Study, this is given to us. Okay. So, this method study is one study.
हेलो,
हेलो, हेलो, हाँ, नाउ इट इज क्लियरली ना, हेलो,
यस सर।
ओके, लेट अस बी गो टू रिविजन्स ऑफ दिस मेथड स्टडी एंड वर्क मेजरमेंट्स। मेथड स्टडी दैट मीन्स अ स्टडी ऑफ एग्जिस्टिंग मेथड्स, वॉट एवर मेथड ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इट इज गोइंग ऑन, वी हैव टू स्टडी दैट एंड इन दैट मेथड्स एनी प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड टू टाइम्स, रिलेटेड टू वेस्टेज, रिलेटेड टू मैन पावर्स, दैट वी हैव टू सर्च एंड वी हैव टू इस्टेब्लिश द न्यू मेथड्स and that will help us to increase the production and productivity. This is actually method study. method study, again it has been classified into two types, that is motions and micro motions. Motions means our body motions while doing the any work, for example reach to workstations, then grasp the materials, apply the pressure, do the particular works. So this motion, it has been recorded, and which is not important, that motions we have to neglect and establish the new methods for manufacturing. Micro motions, this micro motions means a small activity. Normally assembly of the carburetors, assembly of the any engines, or assembly of the any watch parts, this small assembly while doing, we are using both hands, left hand and right hand. The activity of both hand has been recorded with the help of video or this camera, and which is a not important activity, that will neglect and establish the new method. Okay, so this is about the method study. Now work measurements, what is the actual work measurements? Work measurements means while doing any job, while in machining any job, while casting any job, while forging any jobs, while molding any job, while die casting any jobs, we have to decide the standard times. And while deciding the standard times, we have to check the performance of that worker. Okay, and this standard times, it is applicable to all. So this standard times, it has been based upon the qualified workers working style. Okay, so here we have to check the level of performance and decide the standard times for doing a job. So normally in industry we are using stopwatch. 2-3 types of stopwatch are there. Once again work measurement chapters we are going to study, and we have to decide the standard times. Okay, so this is related to jobs to jobs. But again one more method is there, work sampling. Work sampling, whenever mass production is going on, it is very difficult to check the all components. Under such situations, we have to take 4-5 samples, and with help of that samples, by using the statistic methods, we have to decide the standard deviations. Okay, and we have to follow whatever standard deviations we have got, that we have to follow. So this is about the work study. Actually this work study is the one of the subject. Method study, our chapter number 2, is the part of work study. Correct. Now work study, it is classified into two types, method study and work measurements. Method study means we have to study about the existing methods. For example, present forging, present machining, present molding, we have to study this. And which are unnecessary things, maybe downtimes, maybe the problem of the machinings, maybe problem of temperatures. So whatever unwanted, because of that, there is effect on production. So that things we have to avoid in existing methods and develop new method. This is called method study. Correct. So in simple way, method study, that means study of existing methods, and whatever unwanted things are there, that we have to neglect and develop the new method, establish new method. This is called method study. Now under this, again motions and micro motions are. Motions means all our body activity. For example, I want to start any machines, I will have to reach there, grasp that buttons, then turn this. So turn, go to that, hold. These are the basic body motions that we have to study, and which is not important, that we have to neglect and re-establishment of these methods. So this is a motion study. And micro motions, small the work, For example, repairing a watch, we are using two hands. Okay, so sometimes you might have observed that while going for assembly, at times both hands we cannot use. Is it correct? So one hand we are using and one hand will remain idle. So through this concept of the work study, it is expected that we have to make utilization of both hands for doing that work. There should not be idle hands, so that productivity will get increased. And this study we have to do with the help of video, film and unwanted activity that we have to neglect and develop new method. And here work measurement, stopwatch and work sampling. Stopwatch actually we are using for machining purpose, forging or any others whenever batch production is there. And whenever mass production is there, we are using work sampling. So as per our syllabus, the method study is the parts. Okay, so we will go for this method study. So what is the definition of method study? Method study, that means study of existing methods and develop new method. This is the best way. But systematically, if you want to write these definitions in our paper, etc., then method study, it is the technique of systematic recording. Means present method is there, we have to study, record that. Critical examinations, means we have to go for examinations of the present method. And proposed way of doing work and develop easier and economical methods. Means we have to study the present methods and record it. Critical examinations of existing and proposed way of doing that work by keeping two points. That methods means proposed method should be easier and economical. Now what is the objective of this method study? Objectives of method study. Why it is expected this need of method study in our industry? So first thing is improvement. Improvement. Which type of improvement is required? Manufacturing process. First improvement we required, that is the manufacturing process. For example, sir, present method of die casting. So is there any scope for improvement? We have to study, and if possible you have to go for improvement so that your production and productivity will increase. Then next is the procedures. Process, if you want to change little bit, you can think. Otherwise, the work of doing, that is called procedures. If you want to change that process so that the product will get manufactured economically. Then working conditions, improvement in working conditions. Improvement in working conditions. Which type of working conditions? So that because of this working conditions, so that fatigue will not develop, efficiency of that working people will remain stable. Accordingly, working conditions should be there. Then easy to the work, no troubles, no disturbance, noise should not be there. Even noise is there, we can use the protective atmospheres to avoid that critical noise. Climate conditions, temperatures, okay. And in order to get the motivations, we require the incentive, working hours, management policy, all these things it will comes under the working conditions. So working condition should be good so that everybody from their bottom of the hearts they will work accordingly, production and productivity will get increased. Then next is the plant layout. Plant and workplace. Plant and workplace. In plant means that organization, the plant having good transportation facility, crane should be there, not any single material handles by the workers, the personal facility should be there, then materials moving from one place to next place, there should be the particular facility like trolley, etc. So that fatigue will not develop. Accordingly, plant layout should be there. According to productions, maybe process or product layout should be there. Workplace, where we are doing the work, it should be good, nice, should not be effect, psychological effect on the man. And if there is a problem, we have to go for improvement of the same. Okay. Then equipment designs. Equipment designs. What is actually equipment design? Equipment designs, whenever accuracies are there, we have to go for manufacturing of jigs fixture. Accordingly, you have to design the jigs fixture. This is the improvement, and by using that equipment design, definitely checking times will get avoided, good accuracy will be there. Whenever jigs fixtures are there, you have to get good accuracy, loading unloading times, checking times will get avoided. This is the improvement. Then utility of triple M. Utility of triple M. Utility of triple M. What is triple M? Man, materials and machines. Means whatever the capacity of the man, capacity of the machines and availability of material, according to use that all resources, so that there should not be wastage, should not be feel fatigue to the workers, machines will not be works more than that capacity. Means the maximum utilizations of the resources, materials, man and machines. Okay. And last ones, that is the safety. Safety. Improvement in safety. Correct. If safety environment is not there, accident will happen and unnecessary wastage of money will be there. Blame to that industry. Laws will play important roles. This thing will be there. So this, by method study, we are getting this type of objectives in industry. Once again, I will repeat. By using a method study, definitely there is improvement in manufacturing process. Procedure of doing the work, that will get improved. Working conditions in that plant, it should be good. Plant and workplace should be nice. Equipment design so that the maximum output will be there by using jigs fixture. All material, machines and this man's maximum utilization should be there, and safety environment would be there. Okay. So these are the main objective of method study. Improvement point of view, but reducing point of view, if you want to reduce something by using this reducing, reducing which things we can reduce by using method study, first thing is cost. Cost we can reduce. Okay. Second thing is the material handling. Material handling. third thing is the waste material. And fourth one is downtime. So by using this method study, this thing we are going to reduce. Cost should be less so that more profit. Material handling should be automatic by using crane, trolley, etc. Should not be handled by man or worker, so that particular occurs. Waste material. So material utilization should be maximum. There should not be more material waste. And the downtimes means unnecessary times we have to convert into productive times. So by this method study, we can make use of this thing. And last thing is there, methods to be standardized. Third point. Standardizations. Methods to be standardizations. Once we will calculate the standard times for doing job, and that is fixed, and it should be standardized. Standardized means if anything will get worn or torn or it will get break, similar things we can fit. In any more example, suppose nut threads will get worn. We can purchase new nut and we can fit this. Means that nut part is standardized. Replaceable part means methods, any problem is there, so we have to replace that thing, that should be standardized. Means interchangeability. If we want to change any part, replace it, because both parts are standard, nut and bolt. Nut and bolt assembly, I have given this. Nut and bolt, it is manufactured anywhere. But if you take the assembly in one of the isolated place, then even also that assembly will take place. That means nut and bolt is standardized. This method actually be standardization. So these are the objective of the method study. Okay. So now we'll go for basic procedure for method study. Already I have given an example of method study. Any forging industry, any casting industry, any forming industry, you can make utilization of method study. Existing method you have to study and develop new methods by critical examinations and recording. So many procedures points are there that I will going to display. Now, objective of the method study, three types of objectives are there. Improvement in manufacturing process, procedure, working condition, plant and workplace, equipment design, utility of materials, man and machines, safety environment should be there. So by method study, second point, it is expected to reduce the cost. Material handling should not be handled by man's, automatic material handling system should be there. Waste material, maximum utilization of the raw material to develop product, less wastage should be there. There should not be any downtime. If there is a downtime, there is a loss of that production and productivity. And this method, which methods will going to develop new method, that method should be standardized. Standardization means fixed dimension, no change at all. Nut and bolt examples I have given. So these are the objectives of method study. Now we'll go for procedures for method study. Now method study. What is the procedure for method study? Suppose any forging shop, it is given to you, and make utilization of method study, means study of present methods and develop new methods. In that basic procedure, first point is your select, job select. So while selecting a job, which point you have to remember? Three points you have to remember while selecting a job. While selecting a job, three points you have to remember. First point, economical. Second point, humans. Human problem. And third point is technical. So while selecting any jobs for method study, first point, select a job. Which job should be there? Economical means manual works, material handling, repetitive, any problems in the production while handling. If there is a more cost or more money will get waste while doing this work, then we have to think over that particular jobs. Particularly repetitive jobs, that is the most economical things while going for a method study, because repetitive job, even a small cost we can save, then huge amount of money we can save. So while selecting a job for method study, you have to select such job because of that job, economical things will going to change. Then second, humans problem, if it is there, easily accepted to the ground floor workers, and nobody will oppose to study of method study, psychological study of the worker also, you can go through this. Technical problems, which jobs having which machines, what is their capacity, speed, feed, depth of cut. For example, if you want to do any one job, first of all you have to think what is the speed in that machine, how much depth of cut we will take, how much feed we can apply. So if there is a problem while applying the speed, feed, depth of cut, then you have to think over this for method study. Then capacity of the machine. Sometimes we have the 100 jobs capacity of machine, but we are not doing 100 jobs. One day we are finishing 50 jobs. So we are not utilizing that machine as per their capacity. These technical points you have to select. So first procedures in method study, select jobs for method study. While selecting a job for method study, these points you have to remember. This is normally for repetitive work, mass production is there. This is about the workers. Okay, maybe incentive. Always you have to make that all worker happy so that efficiency will get increased, productivity will get increased, correct. And technical point, you have to make use of all the machinery or technology things as per their capacity, correct. So capacity, maximum utilization of the manpowers, and economical means mass production. Based upon these three points, you have to select a job. After selecting, you have to go for recording. Record. Once you have selected a job by using these three points, next point you have to go for recording. Now, a recording purpose, details of existing methods recorded by using different types of symbols. So recording, how we can done the recording? By using the symbol. Symbols are there. These symbols are by using the symbol, which symbols are there? Operation symbol is there, then inspection symbols is there, then transportation is there, then storage is there, and delete. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 symbols we can use for recording purpose. Okay, so 5 symbols we can make utilizations for recording purpose. First round circle is there, so this round circles we can use for operation purpose. Square or rectangulars we can use for inspection purpose. Arrow is there, transportations. Triangle is there, storage purpose. And the just like capital D, that is the delay. Okay, so by using these symbols we can go for recording. Now while recording we required charge. We required charge. So these charts are there. Chart. Recording chart. Recording chart. First chart, that is operations or outline. Process chart. This is the one of the charts used for recording purpose. Then a second chart, that is the flow process chart. Third one, that is the 200 process charts. Then fourth, multiple activity charts. And fifth, that is the flow diagram. And sixth one is string diagram. String diagram. So recording purpose, under this method study, basic procedure, first procedure select. By using this 3 points you have to select a job. After that recording, we can use this symbol. Operations, inspection, transportation, then here storage, and this is the delay. D stands for delay. And under this we are using these charts. Operations or outline process chart, flow process charts, 200 process chart, multiple activity chart, flow diagram, and string diagram. So step by step we are going to study. So this operation or outline process charts, this is called bird's eyes. Bird's eyes means here we can check only operation and inspection. We can make the chart by using operations and inspection. Flow process is continuous flow of the material. That should be Hello. Any problem?
Hari am bolge.
Hello. Hello. Anybody having any problem? Hello. No. Okay. Recording charts. That is the operations outline process chart, flow process chart, 200 process chart, multiple activity and flow diagram and string diagram. So flow diagram and string diagram, this is both this used for movement purpose, man or material movement. Multiple activity, more than one activity is there, so we can use this. 200 process chart by using left and right. Flow process chart means flow of the materials from raw material to the finished, how the material will get flow. And operation or outline process chart, this is also called bird's eyes, means only overlooking is required. Okay, so let us I will give one examples to you. So one examples, so this is the one example. We are manufacturing these parts in our workshop. This is also called the gear blank, or next name is called the gear of the planetary gearbox. Now presently production of this part, it is going in our workshop. How we can make the operations or outline process chart? Okay, for this job, how we can make use of operation or outline process charts? This is very simple, so I will show to you. Now next thing, after inspection means here raw material, hacksaw, operations, then inspection. Now this material, it will go to the our CNC machine. What things will be there? Here OD turning, this is the operations. OD turning is there. After OD turning, we'll go for inspections. OD inspection. Then after that, step turning means once again the operations will be there. These steps will be there. Step turning. Then inspections will be there. After this inspections, boring will be there. Boring operations will be there. And after this inspections. Correct. Now this after inspections, this will go to the VMC. Now in this VMC, again, the one operation is called drilling operations. After that, inspections operations will be there. After this, chamfering means one operations will be there. After this, inspections. Okay, and after this, it will go to the outside. Correct. So, this is the operation or outline process chart. Now here, how many process we have used, how many operation you have used, that you have to count. So here operations, and inspections. So how many operation is there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you can write 6 operation. Inspection 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Correct. So after each operation, there should be inspections. Okay. So this is our flow process chart. This is our outline process chart or operation charts. You can make like this way. Correct. So this is our outline process chart or flow process charts by using this ring gear. Okay. So you can make like this for any jobs. Any jobs you can make the operation or outline process chart. Now in these charts, which are the unexpected operation, or whether we can reduce the inspections, that you have to think. Now raw materials, if we cut on this hex or bend saw, cutting size it is expected to check, otherwise final products will not be correct. So here operation must be there, inspection must be there. Now next on CNC, OD turning is there, correct. OD turning, while doing that OD turning, at the same time you can go for step turning. So this additional operation we have to do with combination of this OD turning. Correct. At the same time boring we can do. Correct. So if it is possible to do the OD turning, step turning and boring at a time, means one operation, 1, 2, 3, instead of 3 operation, we can make one operation and one inspection. Instead of this, suppose here I will make only one operation and one inspection, that means here we can reduce operation, we can reduce. Okay. Now within one setting, if it is possible to make step turning, OD and ID within the one setup, then the inspection also we can reduce. Correct. Now once it will go to the VMC machine, VMC machines nowadays we are making G-gun fixtures. But before G-gun fixture, we used to go for clamping on the VMC machine. So by method study, we have developed jigs fixture on VMC so that we can put number of job here in order to increase the production and productivity, and within the one setting we can take out around 8 jobs, and after that inspection will be there. And here while drilling, if we combine the drilling and chamfering at a time, then these two operations we can reduce. So you have to think over the present methods and which operation or which inspections that will going to reduce, you have to think. Okay, either one operations or one inspection. And if you think over this, then you have to make up operations or outline process charts and calculate the time required for doing a job. So this is our operation or outline process. So in this process chart, we are used only these two symbols. This is the operation symbol and inspection symbol. Other symbols we have not used. These transportation symbols we have not used. Storage symbols we have not used. Delay symbols we have not used. Okay, so only in operation outline process charts we have to study about the major things, operation and inspection, that's all. Correct. So operation and inspection only we have to study under this operation or outline process. Only bird's eyes means major things we have to study, and in that study which things should be there? Operation and inspection. And by putting all these things on papers, you have to study which operations we can neglect, which inspection steps we can neglect, and accordingly we can neglect and calculate the time required for existing methods, and after improvement what should be the time required for new method. If there is a difference, you can go for manufacturing of the same product as per new method. So main purpose to reduce the cost, increase the production and productivity. Okay, so that's why we require this operation or outline process chart. So already I have given one examples to you about the our 95 gear blank in our CNC and VMC machine shop. Initially what we are doing there, we are cutting the materials, after that inspections, after that we are sending to the CNC, turning should be there, after turning inspection, after inspection step turning is there, after step turning inspection is there, after inspection boring should be there, boring after boring the inspection should be there, and then it will send to the VMC. Correct. So in this study we can reduce. Now here's on VMC, if you use jig or fixture, inspection is not required. At a time chamfering should be there. So here we can do like this way. Correct. Means drilling and chamfers at a time. Drilling and chamfers at a time, and here you can use a jig or fixture. So if you use a drill along with chamfers, means at a time drilling and chamfer, and jigs fixture accordingly, so within the one operations the product will get machines and final inspection should be. So this much times we can save. Correct. So this is the actually things we try to understand in the operations or outline process charts. So whenever on the you are in the shop floors, you have to study about the present methods and make the operations or outline process chart. Only two symbols you have to use, operation and inspection. And try to think only on operation and inspection in such way that is it possible to reduce the operation? If possible, you can make that without affecting on the production. Means production, either it may remain constant or it will get increased, but production should not decrease. And productivity also will get increased. Okay, so this is about the operations or outline process chart. So up to here it is clear. So anybody having any doubt, you can ask me. Hello. Hello. Anybody having any problems, you can ask me. Hello. Anybody having any doubt, you can ask regarding mentor study. Very simple conceptual thing. Tomorrow we cover the remaining chart. I have given our examples, our workshop. Anyone should be in the college can come to workshop and study about the mandate process of our job and get it into the outline procedure or operation procedure. Only one thing is to remember in the charts, two symbols we do, eight questions are just given, each symbol operation of the number. And as possible, I have one of the three, which is either operation or investigation, that time we can reduce. Okay. So anybody having any problems, you can ask. Hello? Anybody having any problems related to this method study? Any doubt is there, you can ask. Hello?
No, sir.
Okay. Tomorrow or afternoons, there is one more lecture. In that lecture, if possible, we can cover. Otherwise, we can take one chapter test based on this method study. Okay. So, shall we stop here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we will stop here. Our time is over. So, up to here, if anybody having any question, etc., you can ask in afternoon lecture. Okay, thank you.